invite the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, to address the August gathering.
President Hollande, Excellencies, industry leaders, let me begin once again by expressing solidarity with the people of France and our deepest admiration for being such an outstanding host to the world. In a difficult moment, to my long cherished dream of an international alliance of solar-rich countries, President Hollande responded with keen interest and immediate and full offer of support. This is the inaugural day of a defining global conference on climate change. For his support at every step and his decision to co-chair the launch, I'm deeply grateful. Just as positive was his response to the idea of a book of quotations on nature from the world to remind us all of our timeless wisdom. I'm honored to co-author the preface with him. Since ancient times, different civilizations have given a special place to sun. In the Indian tradition, sun is the source of all forms of energy. As Rigveda says, sun god is the soul of all beings, moving and non-moving. Many in India begin their day with a prayer to the sun. Today, when the energy source of our industrial age have put our planet in peril, the world must turn to sun to power our future. As the developing world lifts billions of people into prosperity, our hope for a sustainable planet rests on a bold global initiative. It will mean advanced countries leaving enough carbon space for developing countries to grow. That is natural climate justice. It also means a growth path with lighter carbon footprint. So convergence between economy, ecology, and energy should define our future. The vast majority of humanity is blessed with generous sunlight round the year. Yet, many are also without any source of power. This is why this alliance is so important. We want to bring solar energy into our lives and homes by making it cheaper, more reliable, and easier to connect to grid. We will collaborate on research and innovation. We will share knowledge and exchange best practices. We will cooperate on training and building institutions. We will discuss regulatory issues and promote common standards. We will attract investment in the solar sector, encourage joint ventures, and develop
innovative financing mechanisms. We will partner with other international initiatives on renewable energy. There is already a revolution in solar energy. Technology is evolving. Costs are coming down and grid connectivity is improving. It is making the dream of universal access to clean energy become more real. India has a capacity of 4 gigawatt, and we have set a target of adding 100 gigawatt of solar power by 2022. By the end of next year, we would have installed another 12 gigawatt. I am delighted with the industry response. As you put clean energy within the reach of all, it will create unlimited economic opportunities. That will be the foundation of the new economy of this century. This is an alliance that brings together developed and developing countries, governments and industries, laboratories and institutions in a common enterprise. India will be pleased to host this initiative at the premises of our National Institute of Solar Energy. We will provide land and contribute $30 million to build the secretariat infrastructure. We will support operation for 5 years, and together we will raise long-term funds to achieve our prescribed goals. This day is the sunrise of new hope, not just for clean energy, but for villages and homes still in darkness, and for our mornings and evenings filled with a clear view of the glory of the sun. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Honorable Prime Minister.